President Yoweri Museveni has called on religious leaders in the Chigezi sub-region to promote development within their communities, noting that this will contribute not only to the growth of the church, but also to the broader progress of the nation. The president's message was delivered over the weekend by David Bahati, the state minister for trade, industries and cooperatives, during the Bishop's Development Fund BDF launch, which took place at St. Peter's Cathedral Rugarama Crowns in Kabale Municipality. Minister Bahati also delivered President Museveni's contribution of 150 million shillings to support the project and highlighted the pivotal role Christians can play in the nation's socio-economic transformation. He encouraged leaders to guide people in identifying productive ventures within these sectors to enhance their wealth and the nation's overall development.
The four sectors for creating wealth and jobs are commercial agriculture, industrialization, services, and ICT. I call upon the leaders to help our people to identify productive ventures in each of these sectors.
The initiative by the Diocese of Chigezi aims to construct a modern shopping mall in Kabale Municipality, estimated to cost 3 billion shillings. The BDF project represents a new approach by the church to engage in self-sustaining ventures that will uplift the region economically. Henry Musasizi, the State Minister for Finance General Duties, also spoke at the event, praising Bishop Gadi Akanjuna for leading the Diocese of Chigezi along a developmental path.
I am already pushing that is on supplementary to cover a billion makumyabiri. Hati wakabanza bilio na vilemwe na vyotu bilimu. Mwene chochombe ku, chilikulete la elitansia, kekanisi. Habu kuweji banki ya chikwanyo.
During the event, over 1.2 billion shillings was raised to construct the shopping mall. The NRM Electoral Commission, led by Tanga Odoi, has called for expression of interest to fill the vacant position, which includes the position of a woman member of parliament and local government councillors, including special interest groups. He added that this activity precedes the minor resignation within the district, which saw eligible voters who had missed the registration captured in the party register, a process that ended on 21st of September.
It is in line with our Article 39.10 of the NRM Constitution that we call for expression of interest and pick nomination forms for those eligible to contest to replace the late Sarah Mateke as a member of parliament, district woman member of parliament for Kisoro.
Among other vacant positions to be filled include the woman member of parliament for Chisoro district, district woman councillor for South Division, municipal male older persons councillor for Northern Division, municipal male PWD councillor for Northern Division, sub-county male youth councillor for Shahafi Town Council, and the sub-county female PWD councillor for Bunagana Town Council. Odoi highlighted some of the qualifications for one to express interest in contesting for the position of a woman member of parliament.
Must have verified or certified O and A level. Must not be employed in an organization wholly owned by the government of Uganda. We shall give you this document. Must not be a registered member of the armed forces, the army, the police, the prison. If you're a member of the army, prison, police, and you've not resigned or retired, you don't qualify. The date for expression of interest. Expression of interest starts today, Monday the 23rd, till Monday 30th September.
The Ministry of Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities, MTWA, in collaboration with the Uganda Wildlife Authority, UWA, has called for an additional $11 million to safeguard Uganda's endangered rhino population. The call was made during the World Rhino Day at Ziwa Rhino and Wildlife Conservation Sanctuary in Nyaki Thomas of County Nakasongola District. MWTA also launched a rhino naming campaign for rhino conservation efforts and habitat management, from which most money for the conservation will be generated. Minister for Tourism, retired Colonel Tom Butime, emphasized the urgency of translocating white rhinos to Ajaya Wildlife and other national parks to enhance protection efforts. Butime said the campaign aims at attracting individuals with financial muscle, companies and organizations, among other entities, to christen their preferred names to rhinos at Ziwa Rhino and Wildlife Conservation Sanctuary.
Fencing and protect them first, because you just don't drop them. You just drop them and go away. You have to make an enclosure. Yes, you have to make an enclosure, track them, protect them, then after some time when they have expanded, increased, this and this, and they have become more habituated in the area, then you can let them stay without close supervision. Like here now they are safe now, I think.